Growing Focal is a growing group that's based in the Linley area of Huddersfield. We started it during lockdown. The idea is to have a social, it's a social thing. You don't necessarily have to be into gardening. And we want to grow veg to give away to the community in the end when we've got enough space. We're in the process at the moment of putting some ideas together for plants so that we can sell them, because there's a dog show soon. So we're going to have a stall, and then that'll raise money to obviously continue the group.
So as you come into Focal Community Centre, we've got two special places at the front which are quite poignant. One is in memory of a neighbour called Gordon. He's no longer with us, but rhubarb he loved, and he grew profusely in his garden, but he didn't know how to cook it, and neighbours came together and made him rhubarb crumble and rhubarb pie. So that's there to remind us. And further up underneath the Focal sign, we've got a special place for one of our team who comes every week in memory of someone special to her, and it's Peter's place. And we try to make sure there's colour there all year round. Also at the front, we've got a beautiful herb garden, which is now vastly overgrown, and that's there for people who are walking past who might decide that they want to have some salmon and some tarragon, can just pop in and take some tarragon home, or basil or whatever other herbs are there. They're there to share, and that is the general idea of Growing Focal. We share what we have.
So the feedback has been they feel a lot better, they look forward to coming, it's taken care of, you know, they have a point to get up and come here in the morning. We've got some lovely quotes, and also a lot of them are now meeting outside the group.
The whole idea of social prescribing is to complement the medical side of it. So what you find is that the clinicians will do all the clinical stuff, and in theory is if we can get the social prescribing right, or the social life and all the other background things, then it helps them to heal better. To be quite honest, it's worked really well, because from not knowing each other, they're sort of like grown together. And you know, when you say, well, I call it growing focal, and I can actually see them growing together, and they're quite good, because they're actually supporting each other now.
It has been important to come out. I was getting really, really depressed, and I come here every Wednesday now, and it really books you up. Well, the kind of things we've been growing is corn, potatoes, strawberries, tomatoes, cabbage, cauliflowers, broccoli, onions, all the herbs. We've grown everything. It's been absolutely brilliant.
It's helped with my mental health a lot. Just meeting the same group of ladies every week has really helped, and we're a good core group as well.
I've been involved with this from the beginning, and I don't shed a tear very often, but I've shed a couple of tears here.
The best three things is coming here, making friends, just talking to different people and learning different things, actually. Yeah.
Meeting everybody out in the fresh air and growing food we can eat.
We're going to go and harvest the cauliflower. There should be sufficient for everyone to take some cauliflower home. And one of our team has volunteered to make some cauliflower soup. And on this rainy summer's day, that'll be most welcome. We've got three signs that we tend to have look at on the wall. One is a beautiful picture of a bee, because of course we want to be sustainable. And one says, make yourself a home, and I hope everybody who comes here does make themselves a home.
Third Sector Leaders have been fantastic, supportive through COVID. They've provided us with larger chunks of funding, smaller chunks of funding. They advise us where to go for other types of funding. They do loads of courses that our staff can access as well, both short and longer courses. I don't know what we'd have done without them, to be fair. The health inequalities funding, we used it to rent the building, because obviously this is a community building and they have to survive and pay the bills like everybody else. We use it for staff and a lot of the equipment, because we were quite shocked at how much equipment you needed. So that was generally what it's been used for.
Well, groups like this are so important, because it's relationships, isn't it? It's forming relationships, building relationships, and life is about relationships. And if you can talk to somebody and you've got somebody to share your... You know, they always said a problem shared is a problem halved, don't they?
Yeah, just come and take part. We're a friendly bunch, and we get the benefit of eating lovely food afterwards.
Got another motto on the wall, which is be good, be happy and be kind. And what a wonderful place it would be if everybody followed that motto.